Today we start chapter number 15, that is plant growth and development. Now in this chapter, we'll study about the plant growth regulators, which are also known as plant hormones or phytohormones, because they control the all the activities in the plant, that is promoting activities as well as inhibiting activities. This is what it is written as PGR, that is plant growth regulators. These are small chemical substances and with varying type of composition, different composition, and they present in the plant and control various type of activities like their growth, development, flowering, fruiting, etc. So that's why they are known as plant growth regulators. These are of two types, depending upon which type of activity they perform, which type of activity they control. They are of two types. Some hormones which
effect or which
control the plant growth, they are responsible for inducing the growth, they are known as plant growth promoters, and which are inhibiting the some activities in the plant, they are known as plant growth inhibitors. And there are, we know that there are five types of hormones in plants, and these are auxin, gibberellin, then cytokinins, ABA, that is abscisic acid, and ethylene. Out of these, ethylene is present in gaseous form and others in liquid form. They are synthesized in the plant in various ways, different activities. And they are nowadays also synthesized in artificially in the laboratory also, and they are used for that purpose. Different purposes. Now, these plant growth promoters, how they are developed, how they are controlling various activities in plant, that was discussed through the slide, diagrams, line diagrams, etc. But now we study that ethylene is responsible for the fruiting, as well as other activities are also, and some of the activities are inhibited by this ethylene. ABA is known as the antagonistic hormone of this gibberellin, because whatever the functions gibberellin is doing, that is inhibited by ABA. For example, gibberellin is responsible for the opening of stomata, then ABA is responsible for the closing of stomata. Gibberellin induces seed germination, whereas ABA is responsible for inhibiting the process of seed germination. Gibberellin will stop the process of dormancy. Then that means ABA is responsible for seed dormancy, whereas gibberellin will break the dormancy. Then gibberellin is responsible for the leaf fall, fruit fall, prevention of leaf fall, whereas ABA for the leaf fall, inducing that. So in this way, these two are antagonistic in their function. Cytokinins are responsible for the growth and development by cell division, etc. Auxin is also there for curvature, apical dominance, etc. So these are various plant promoters, these are various plant growth inhibitors. They control different activities in the plant in various ways that we'll discuss through this slides now.
In plants, some chemicals are present in small quantities, but they are controlling various activities, growth, development, and other activities in plant. They are known as plant hormones or phytohormones or plant growth regulators. Now, these are categorized into two types, that is growth promoter as well as growth inhibitor. In growth promoter, three are there, that is auxin, cytokinin, and gibberellin, whereas growth inhibitors are ethylene and abscisic acid. Ethylene is present in the gaseous form. Abscisic acid, also known as ABA hormone. This we can see different types of activities which are controlled by this hormones in plants, like stomata closing and opening is controlled by abscisic acid and cytokinin. Development of abscission zone is controlled by ethylene, auxin, etc. Then growth of young fruits controlled by cytokinin, whereas the ripening of fruit is controlled by ethylene. The root development is under control of this auxin, and auxin also control various other activities, then that is apical dominance, etc. Then the control of stem elongation is controlled by auxin as well as gibberellic acid. The initiation of flowering occurs through the hormone that is known as flowering hormone, which is synthesized from the leaves, and then they will reach to the site where the flowering will occur. Then the main step, the main function of the cytokinin is the cell division. So auxin, gibberellic acid and cytokinin helps in the growth by various activities, like this cell division is controlled by cytokinin, the stem elongation controlled by gibberellic acid, auxin, etc. And in this way, various other activities like seed germination, breaking of dormancy, all these things are controlled by various hormones in plants. Here is given the list of the hormones and various functions they control. Like cytokinin affect the cell division, then they are responsible for delaying the senescence. They activate the dormant buds also. Gibberellic acid initiates the mobilization of storage materials in seed during the germination. That means they are responsible for the germination of seed. They are responsible for the elongation of a stem. They stimulate the bolting in biennial plants. Then stimulate pollen tube growth also. Then they are, so these are different types of hormones which are responsible for various activities, like ethylene for ripening of fruits. They promote abscission, then determines the sex in the cucurbits family. Then auxin involves in the differentiation of vascular tissue, control the cellular elongation, prevention of abscission. They also enhance the fruit development. They stimulate the release of ethylene. They involve in apical dominance. Various type of tropism are also controlled by this auxin. Abscisic acid maintains the dormancy in seeds and buds. They stimulate the closing of stomata. This abscisic acid is also known as the antagonistic hormone of this gibberellin, because both of these two are doing the opposite functions. They are opposite in their functions. Then salicylic acid also present in the plant for different activities. Jasmonate. So they are these are the list of hormones performing different functions in the plant. The discovery of auxin was first done by Charles and Francis Darwin in 1881. They reported that some experiments on the response of growing plants to light associated to phototropic response, and they occur in very low concentration, but they are controlling various activities. They are isolated from human urine also, in coleoptiles also. So differential response depending on the dose, how much dose are given to the plant, they will perform various different types of activities. So this is the structure of this auxin, and they are performing the activity that in which the plant is moving towards the phototropism. The phototropism is controlled by this hormone, and this we can see in this. Cytokinin was discovered by Gottlieb Haberlandt in 1913, then in 1941 by Johnson von Overbeek, in 1954 Jawlensky and Skog, and they have isolated the first cytokinin as kinetin in 1955, and it was done by Miller. The first naturally occurring cytokinin is geatine, which was isolated in 1961 by Miller only. Then it is naturally occurring cytokinins are extracted from this coconut milk, tomato juice, then flowers and fruits like pear, plum, the cambium tissue of Eucalyptus nicotina, then immature fruits of G. maize, Musa species, then root exudates of sunflower. So these are the naturally occurring cytokinins. The cytokinins found in plant are, the category is geatine, dihydrogeatine, then ribostylogeatine. So these are the categories which are present in the plant. They are known as the growth regulators, because they the important function is that they help in the process of cell division, enhance the process of cell division, and hence they are utilized in the process of this tissue culture along with the auxin. a root derived factor required for shoot growth in culture, and this is a factor in endosperm that promotes cell division in culture, and hence they are utilized as in the process of tissue culture. They also performed various activities, and that we'll see in the next slide. Cytokinin is another plant hormone which performs various activities in the plants, and they are also known as growth promoters. They are known as kinetin are found to be derivative of the purine base adenine, which bears for furyl substituent at the 9th position, which migrated to the 6th position of the adenine during the autoclaving of DNA. So this is the structure of kinetin. Then this helps in the process of cell division. They promote cell division, then morphogenesis, that is the morphology development, then lateral bud development. They delay the senescence, then responsible for the opening of stomata. They helps in rapid transport in xylem stream. So in this way they perform various type of activities in the plant. ABA hormone, or this abscisic acid, present in the vascular plant, then mosses, fungi, etc., and responsible for various activities like closing of stomata, inhibit the seed germination and development, then they control the process of dormancy. So in this way they perform various activities like abscission of fruit, leaf, etc., that is fruit fall, leaf fall, etc., all are controlled by the abscisic acid, and hence they are known as the inhibitor, plant inhibitors. Gibberellins, or the gibberellic acid, are also the plant hormone and comes under the category as a plant growth regulator. They mainly stimulate the elongation of internodes, and hence they are responsible for the growth in the plants. It was discovered by Yabuta and Hayashi in 1939, and the first isolated gibberellic acid was from the fungus, that is Gibberella fujikuroi, and this is also known as the foolish disease of rice. The movement of gibberellin is non-polar, and about 125 types of gibberellins are nowadays been isolated and discovered. GA1, that is gibberellic acid 1, and gibberellic acid 20 are widely distributed in higher plants. Different categories are GA1, GA2, GA3, etc. Various activities or the functions which are controlled by this gibberellic acid is stem elongation, seed germination, growth of the seedlings. They helps in the process of breaking of seed dormancy. Then they enhance the process of this seed germination. They promote bolting and flowering, and long day plant, cold requirement. Then they also helps in the flowering, then sex expression of the plant. So all these are controlled by this hormone, that is gibberellic acid or gibberellin.